professor in the Chemical Engineering Department of LG IIT Ahmedabad. In this lecture, I am going to start new topic of the mass transfer operation, that is nothing but gas absorption. You can see on the screen, gas absorption. Chapter name is gas absorption and topic name is methods of operation. So what is the meaning of gas absorption? I told you there is a difference between absorption and adsorption. Absorption, it is a bulk phenomena, and adsorption, it is surface phenomena. Means absorbate and absorbent terms are involved in absorption, and adsorbate and adsorbent, these terms involved in adsorption. Means whatever the molecule is absorbing in another substance, that molecule is nothing but absorbate. And the substance we are using for the absorbate, to absorb the absorbate, that is nothing but absorbent. And whatever the substance is accumulating over the another surface, on the surface, that is nothing but adsorbate. And the surface which we are using, that is nothing but adsorbent. Means adsorbate and adsorbent, these two terms are involved in adsorption, and absorbate and absorbent, these terms are involved in absorption. I am repeating, in adsorption, we are using the substance for the adsorption. Means we are using the surface of any substance, that surface substance is known as the adsorbent. And we are accumulating the substance over the surface, that substance is nothing but adsorbate. And in absorption, we are accumulating the substance inside of the another substance, that another substance is nothing but absorbent. And whatever the substance we are accumulating inside, that is nothing but absorbate. And in gas absorption, we are absorbing one of the component from the gaseous mixture by using liquid, that is nothing but gas absorption. And here we are going to study now methods of operation. You can see on the screen, two methods of contacting the gas and liquid are possible. First one is counter current operation and co-current operation. In counter current operation, both steam, means gaseous steam and liquid steam, are coming from the opposite directions. And in co-current operations, both steam are coming from the same direction. So this is the difference between counter current mode and co-current mode. We will see all these topics in detail in next slides. But before that, you can see on the screen, this is the whole phenomena of the gas absorption. I told you, in gas absorption, we are removing one of the component from the gaseous mixture by using liquid. So you can see here, one stream is for the liquid and another stream for the gaseous stream. So you can see, stream coming from the bottom section to the top section, that is nothing but gaseous stream. And stream coming from the top section to the bottom section, that is nothing but liquid stream. And here, we are removing component from the gaseous stream by using liquid stream. So you can see here, various terms are involved. First of all, you can see there is one block. In that block, there are two arrows. First arrow is coming from the bottom section to the top section, that is nothing but gaseous stream. And another arrow there is present, that is nothing but coming from the top section to the bottom section, that is nothing but liquid stream. And here we are removing component from the gaseous stream by using this liquid stream. Okay. Now we will see various terms are involved. Now we will see this figure in detail. Okay. So you can see on the screen now. First one, there is a liquid coming from the top section to the bottom section, and initially in the liquid, there is no solute particle is present. That's why I can say this liquid is a pure in nature, okay, and concentration of the solute material initially present in this liquid is zero, or I can say mole fraction of the solute particle initially present in the liquid is zero. After that, you can see solute content in the liquid phase increases down the column, because here we are absorbing component A from the gaseous stream. That's why this solute component is increasing from the top to bottom. That's why I can see here solute composition is increasing from the top to bottom in the liquid stream. In this manner, we can see here solute composition in the liquid stream is increasing from the top to bottom. After that, you can see outlet stream of the liquid now. Outlet stream means liquid out. Initially, there is no solute present in the liquid stream at the inlet section, but at outlet section, it consists maximum amount of the solute A, because we are absorbing here solute particle from the gaseous stream. That's why liquid out is equal to inert liquid plus absorbed solute A. Similarly, we will see now another stream, that is gaseous stream. Initially, in the gaseous stream, we are having inert gas plus solute A. This solute A, we are removing from this stream by using this liquid stream. Okay, so I can see here in gas inlet stream, we are having maximum amount of the solute A, but in the outlet stream, we are having minimum amount of the solute A, because here we are transferring solute A from the gaseous stream to the liquid stream. That's why I can say gas outlet stream consists of the inert gas plus unabsorbed solute A. I told you in previous lectures as well, no process is 100% efficient, or I can say no solute, or I can say no solvent that is absorbent is 100% efficient. That's why there is no possibility of the 100% absorption of the solute A in the liquid stream. That's why there is some amount of the solute A is also that is unabsorbed, that is present in the gas outlet stream. Okay, so all these things are important in this two outlet stream. Okay, after that you can see another arrow, that is solute contained in the gas phase decreases up the column, because I told you in liquid stream solute content is increases from top to bottom, but in another side you can see there solute content is decreases from the bottom to top, because here we are transferring solute particle from the gaseous stream to the liquid stream. That's why solute content in gas phase decreases up the column. Okay, and mass transfer of the solute A from gas into the liquid, that is nothing but solute A absorbed into the inert liquid. So whole this whole process is nothing but gas absorption. Okay, based on this diagram, 5-mark question can be asked in your exam. Explain in detail gas absorption phenomena with figure. So you have to draw this figure and you have to explain. After that, now we are going to study here different modes of the gas absorption. Modes of the absorption means different methods. First one is the counter current operation, and another one is the co-current operation. Firstly, we will see counter current operation. So in counter current operation, you can see this is the block diagram for the counter current operation. Here we are having two streams. First stream is for the gaseous and second one is for the liquid. Gas stream is coming from the bottom section to the top section, and liquid stream is coming from the top section to the bottom section. And I told you here we are removing component from the gaseous stream to the liquid stream. Okay, means absorbent, that is nothing but liquid. And here this is the block diagram for the counter current operation. Here we are having two streams. First one is the gaseous stream and second one is the liquid stream. Gaseous stream is coming from the bottom section to the top section, and liquid stream is coming from the top section to the bottom section. And here we are removing components from the gaseous stream to the liquid stream, or I can say here we are using absorbent as the liquid. You can see there, first one, there is the G2Y2. This is nothing. Now we will see various notations involved in this block diagram. So you can see on the screen, we will see notation for the inlet streams. That is nothing but G1, Y1, L1, X1. So what is the meaning of G1? Capital G1 is nothing but flow rate for the gaseous stream at the inlet section. After that, L1 is nothing but flow rate for the liquid stream at the inlet. Now we will see notations involved in this figure. So first one is capital G1 and capital L1. Capital G1 is nothing but flow rate for the gaseous stream at the inlet section, and capital L1 is nothing but flow rate of the liquid stream at the outlet section. After that, Y1. Small Y1 is nothing but mole fractions of the solute A present in the gaseous stream, that is nothing but G1 stream. Okay, after that, X1. This is also mole fraction of the solute particle present in the L1 stream. After that, you can see there are outlet streams. Outlet stream means for the gaseous stream and inlet stream for the liquid stream. So G2 is nothing but this is the flow rate of the gas for the outlet stream, and L2 is nothing but flow rate of the liquid for the liquid stream. After that, Y2 and X2. So Y2 is nothing but mole fraction of the component A in the outlet stream of the gaseous stream. After that, X2 is nothing but this is the mole fraction of the component A in the liquid stream. After that, we can take here GYLX. This is at any point in the block diagram, at any point in the absorber, we can say capital G and capital L. These are nothing but flow rates of the gaseous stream and liquid stream respectively. After that, small y and small x. These are nothing but mole fractions of the solute particle. Small y is for the gaseous stream and small x is for the liquid stream. After that, you can see there bottom of the column is represented by 1 and top of the column is represented by the 2. Okay, so this is all about counter current operation. Now we'll see co-current operation. So in co-current operation, this is the figure. You can see both streams, means liquid stream and gaseous stream, coming from the same direction, means coming from the top section to the bottom section. And here various notations are involved. That is, for the inlet stream here, capital L1 and capital G1, these are nothing but flow rates of the liquid stream and gaseous stream respectively for the inlet section. capital L2 and G2, these are nothing but fluorides of the liquid stream and gaseous stream for the outlet section. After that, small x1 and small y1, these are nothing but mole fractions of the solute present in the liquid stream and gaseous stream respectively. After that, small x2 and small y2, these are nothing but mole fraction of the solute particle present in a liquid stream and gaseous stream respectively. After that, at any point in the absorber, there is capital L and capital G and small x and small y. Capital L and capital G, these are nothing but fluorides, and small x and small y, these are nothing but mole fraction of the solute particle which we want to remove. Okay, so this is all about co-current operation and counter-current operation. So what we have seen in this lecture, I have discussed here different methods of the operations for the gas absorption, that is nothing but co-current operation and counter-current operation. After that, I have discussed here detailed phenomena of the gas absorption, that is nothing but you can see here now this figure can be asked for 5 marks in your exam, so you have to study this figure in detail. Okay, here we are. So I told you in this figure that here we are using two streams, and here component A concentration is decreases for the gaseous stream from the bottom section to the top section, and it is increases from the for the liquid for the top section to the bottom section. So these all things are important for the gas absorption, and this question can be asked for the 5 to 7 marks in your final examination. So this is all about this lecture. We'll see next topic in the next lecture. Thank you very much.